very much. Hello and welcome to Good News. So, what have we learnt this week? Well, is it me, or has Jon Snow's interview technique become a bit harsh?
You can only score in a brothel.
Could be worse. Look what David Cameron did to this guy.
Unfortunately, Mr. Cameron decided to start at the bottom and work up.
Did anyone else see the bloke in Parliament who got so bored he started a thumb war with himself?
And the government will discuss the elements of the programme for government, such as upcoming programme for jobs initiative.
And finally, big news of the BBC. Bill and Sean have brought out a sex tape.
Very
saucy it is as well.
From the very beginning.
Yes, you're very adult. Time now, though, but we'll calm down.
Now, the big media story this week was the News of the World phone hacking scandal.
News International today admitted its paper, The News of the World, was responsible for hacking the phones of a number of celebrities and public figures.
Did you see whose phones they were hacking?
News International has offered to pay damages to those who are currently suing the paper. They include the actress Sienna Miller and football commentator Andy Gray.
Andy Gray? Apparently his phone was really tough to hack because Richard Keys kept smashing it. The media have concentrated on Sienna Miller and Andy Gray. I'll be honest, the one that really caught my eye was this. Gaza to sue newspaper over phone tapping. Christ! Imagine listening to this man's phone. You wouldn't be able to tell what was real or what was drunken gibberish. Me and the Queen are getting married. Are you, Gaza? I've invented a time machine that runs on Pringles. Of course you have. I'm going to give a murderer a sandwich. Yeah, whatever, Gaza. I'm not an idiot. What I don't understand, surely, if you're going to hack anyone's phone, it would be this guy. Wouldn't that be great? Wouldn't you love to hear him ringing up Cameron? Dave, just went to Buckingham Palace last night. You were right. The back of the Queen's head doesn't taste like a stamp. The scandal has upset a lot of people. To be honest, I wasn't that fussed. I've actually been tapping some celebrities myself. It's a better way of putting that. No. Hacking celebrities. Check them out, though. It makes for a fascinating listen.
Victoria, it's David. Can you come home immediately? There's a strange man in the house. Sorry, it's a mirror. Forget I called. It's so unfair. Why does everyone hate me? Lonely. So lonely.
I'll tell you what, it's a rot. Ball ain't keeping this act up. I hate dancing. I like football and minge.
I must admit, when I read about this phone hacking, I did think to myself, Christ, I hope they don't get me. They'd have to read all my brother's texts. I got one the other day that said, what does the man with a 10-foot cock have for breakfast? This morning, I had Cocoa Pops. He's relentless. Today, he sent me a picture message that simply said, Russ, I've bought the wrong condoms. These are too small. In other news, David Cameron has been on holiday.
Now, when you're the leader of the country, you can expect a few perks here and there. But when David Cameron took his wife Samantha on a trip to southern Spain, he decided to fly Ryanair.
They flew Ryanair. Oh, I'd love to have seen that. Don't fall asleep, Samantha. The orange lady will take our stuff. She's an air hostess. If you worked in security, you'd definitely make him do a cavity search. What are you looking for? Nick Clegg. The great thing is, he won't be able to complain. Budget airlines really don't give a shit. The customer services departments, there's just blokes on the phone going, hello, customer services, go fuck yourself. Hi, customer services, go fuck yourself. Hello, customer services, go fuck yourself. Sometimes I truly love the news in this country. Have a look at the major crime wave that swept through Norwich.
Donkeys at a sanctuary in Norwich have had more reason than usual to be downhearted. Their favourite toys were recently stolen.
Forget the recession, someone's stolen a toy from a donkey! It gets even better, check out what their favourite toys are. Donkeys in Norwich have their space hopper stolen. What kind of man would steal a space hopper from a donkey? Why are the donkeys playing with space hoppers? Surely they prefer buckaroo. Reminds me of Grandad. I miss him so much. The reason why I love this story is because of the way they've reported it. Listen to the music they play. They make it sound like the donkeys are heartbroken.
We're all sad. George is sad, and Lucky Donkey sad. They have other toys, Wellington boots, boots, flat footballs they like. All ponies and donkeys need something to play with. You know, they get bored.
I'm surprised they didn't show footage of donkeys self-harming. Just Eeyore in a bath dropping a toaster. Life is poo. To be honest, it's little wonder they're upset. Check out their owner's hat.
So we put in a pillow and we're going to spend some time from here, but we can have a room in the garden shed and they can't donate.
Why has she got our dead brother on her head? This story keeps on giving. Suddenly, from nowhere, a journalist turns up with a space hopper. Check out the donkey's reaction.
Here you go, boys. Here you go.
Try as we might, they weren't playing ball.
Because they're donkeys.
Hey, Mr. Donkey, play with the space hopper. Shut off, you crazy cow! I haven't even got thumbs.
I love how angry she gets when they won't play.
They're not vaguely interested. They're not. That cost us £13.
£13! Ungrateful bastards. Hello, is that the Norwich Kebab House? Yeah, I'm bringing in a delivery. Good laugh, man. Sweet. You sound like a randy auntie. You're very welcome. The mad stories keep coming. Next, we're off to a hotel in Bedford who are having trouble with a naughty chair.
Now, I don't know whether you're superstitious, but staff at a hotel in Bedfordshire certainly are. They're avoiding a particular chair because seven of their colleagues who all used it have fallen pregnant within 18 months.
A chair that makes you pregnant. I'm no expert. I think they're sitting on it wrong. Look how scared this reporter gets around the chair.
You don't think I'd really sit on it, do you? It's actually through there.
I love the fact that that chair is getting the blame. I mean, I could understand it if the chair looked like this. But not only are they blaming the blue chair, the manager of the hotel has got big plans for it.
What are you actually going to do with the chair? Are you going to do anything with it now you think it's special?
I think what we may do is mount it somewhere in the hotel so that people can come and pay homage.
Mount the chair? Surely that was the problem in the first place. I'll tell you what, though, if that chair really is responsible, I'd hate to be in the maternity ward. You may remember last week we had the bug that looked like Elvis. The week before we had the Hitler house. Well, incredibly, the papers have come up with another. This week it's a tree that looks like a rock guitarist. Do you want to see it? You know you want it. It's brilliant, isn't it? To be honest, we shouldn't be surprised. If you look hard enough, most trees look like someone, some look like politicians. Some look like film stars. And if you look hard enough, you can even find trees that look like Katie Price. Over in America, check out the latest way to get closer to God.
All right, they love Jesus and they're not afraid to show it in a very interesting way. These church-going women are embracing the dance moves once reserved for strip clubs. It's called Pole Fitness for Jesus.
Pole Fitness for Jesus. No wonder he rose again. Thanks very much. Thanks very much. To be honest, lap dancing would make a lot more people go to church. We are gathered here today to worship our Lord and Saviour. Before that, Cristal is going to dry hump a pole.
The workout is set to Christian music, and class corps say it brings them closer to God.
Brings him closer to God. Makes it sound like he's in heaven. Go work that ass, baby. That's why I made it that way. In fairness, they're not the first people touched by our Lord.
What's happening right now?
Right now?
Are there a hand? Is it burning or just a hand?
Just feel it.
You think it's Jesus?
Yeah.
Thanks, Jesus. That's what I call a second coming. Over in the Czech Republic, there's been an exciting archaeological discovery.
Archaeologists in the Czech Republic claim they have discovered what might just be the world's first known gay caveman.
Or, as the Sun delicately put it, I'm the Stone Age gay in the village. A gay caveman. What next? A lesbian dinosaur. Behold, the Lichosaurus! I love K.D. Lang. Wouldn't it be great if they discovered the gay caveman on Time Team? Look, Tony, these guys were buried fighting. That's no fight. The best thing about this story, he wasn't alone. He was actually buried with three of his mates. Next over to the wonderful country that is Australia. Last week, I showed you a bloke who took his parrot for a ride on his car. This week, check out what their finest scientists are working on.
It's been challenging mankind since we were first blasted off. Can humans drink beer in space?
I'm only going to the moon if I can get shit-faced. To be honest, I think drinking in space is madness. The last thing you want when you meet bizarre intergalactic creatures are beer goggles. She's all right. Dave, she looks like Shrek's bellend. Drinking in space would really have changed Star Wars. Imagine Han Solo pissed. Chewie, you look like a 70s minge. Just Luke Skywalker clutching a bottle of vodka. I can't believe I tried to fuck my sister. The royal wedding draws ever closer. Have you seen the latest wedding memorabilia?
Take a look at crown jewels. That's right. Condoms are being sold in packs of three. They have a picture of the royal couple on the front, and according to the manufacturer, they are lavishly lubed and regally ribbed.
Lavishly lubed and regally ribbed. They make it sound like the Queen is blessing each one.
Arise, Sir Johnny. Do your duty for the Empire. It's Boris Johnson licking back at my head.
Have you seen their catchphrase?
The special celebration pack urges lovers to lie back and think of England.
Lie back and think of England? That'd be horrible. Having sex with a girl and she's going, late trains, wheelie bins, drizzly weather. He's there going, why can't Lampard and Gerrard work together in the midfield? They should get Philip to do the adverts. Royal condom, extra strong. Trust the crown when you're going brown town. The big sports story of the week was, of course, the Grand National. Did you watch the BBC coverage? It was so over the top.
There isn't a person in the country that doesn't know today is Grand National Day.
Ooh, I can think of one.
Mind you, it's a huge draw. All the celebs were there.
Hiya! I'm Colleen Rooney. That's Wayne up there.
I felt a bit sorry for the reporters. They were interviewing the crowd.
I'll read out some horse names and you cheer if you're backing them, OK?
Trouble is, the crowd were pretty hammered.
Oscar time. Yay! Any support for Fergie's What a Friend? No! Yeah. Silver by Nature? Yay! Big fella thanks, anyone? Yay! Are you going to cheer anything I say?
Talking of drinking, some ladies actually thought they were jockeys. Whistling. Not everyone was pissed. Some were betting and getting quite scientific.
I like when they kind of bounce around on the toes, you know. I like a horse that doesn't sort of keep its head down. I like it when it looks up a bit.
I like the jumpy one.
As ever, the winner was a small Irish bloke you couldn't understand.
Delight for jockey Jason Maguire, who could scarcely believe his achievement.
He kind of said we'll try and be in the first 10 because in case he frightens himself, he'll have to be strong maker. But he's half run away from me for the first mile.
Why is it all jockeys are Irish? Being a career officer in Ireland must be a piece of piss. Tall comedian, small jockey, really small leprechaun. Sorry, Dara. One thing I love about the National is the way the commentators talk.
Santa's struggling the big race. Oscar time's just in behind these, followed by the Midnight Club, then Surface to Wear.
Do you know what I'd love to do? Buy a horse and call him, I'm having a nervous breakdown. In fact, I'd buy all the horses in the race, give them all weird names, and make it sound like the commentator was going mad. Wouldn't that be great? They're coming up to the final furlong. I'm having a nervous breakdown ahead of my wife left me over. Pictures on my laptop, not to mention there's a burst pipe in my sex dungeon. Small fry considering last summer I bummed a squirrel towards the rear. Where's that rash come from? Followed by strangle wanking. I should be in therapy because the race hasn't even started. If you think the Grand National was the only equine story of the week, guess again. Prepare to meet a group from California called Pony Play who pretend to be horses.
Anytime you're pretending to be a pony, it's Pony Play.
Pony Play, it looks more like Gimpy Taxi.
Me get in this headspace of thinking that I'm a pony. I no longer have responsibilities of being human. I'm just a pony and I'm pulling my cart.
Imagine going out with her.
I'm a pony. I'm a pony.
You're telling me, love, you're just on a shit on the road. Frighteningly, she isn't the only member of Pony Club. Check out this wheezy loser.
You're kidding me, look at you. Oh, so beautiful.
This is probably as close as I will ever get to riding a horse.
Why is that? Because you live in a city, you can't afford one.
You know, I can't see myself riding an actual horse.
He's vegan.
I'm vegan.
I'm vegan. I can't ride a horse because I'm vegan. I've never had my photo taken because I can't even say cheese.
This is the part of the show I genuinely don't know anything about. There's going to be a mystery guest who's been in the news and I have to figure out who that person is. So, please welcome my mystery guest. Hello.
Hi, Russell.
How are you, man? You all right?
I'm good, thanks. Yeah, take a seat.
Good. Thanks very much. What's your name?
David Jones.
David James, OK.
Jones.
Like, Jones, OK. So, instantly, you're in a cell, and there's some people looking at you, and there's some crime books and a dinosaur book.
OK, have another look at some of the other books.
Some of the books.
To give you a clue.
OK, right, so we've got Mark Thomas. OK. Crime books. Is there anything to do with the biscuits?
No. Go to your right.
Okay. Reptiles.
Right, now you're on the right track.
Right, so randomly you've got crime books.
They're purely random.
It's got nothing to do with that.
Just for reading material.
Living snakes of the world.
Yes.
Reptile. I love that. Yes. So you read books about snakes.
Yes.
When you're bored, books about torture.
It's a strange world. Yes.
So do you have lots of snakes? Is that
I don't have lots of snakes.
You're
not
fond of snakes?
I'm very fond of snakes.
Are you the?
Where am I? What do you think I'm in?
You're in a bed sit.
Yes.
And children are staring at you.
Let's just say people in general.
All right, people are staring at you. Oh, okay. So were you living in a reptile? Bit of a zoo, a reptile centre.
You're very close.
You're gonna have to tell me.
I will tell you. The reason I was in the news is that I broke the world record for living the longest period of time with venomous snakes.
Right. Okay. Wow. Well, that's worth a round of applause, isn't it? There you go. How long is that record?
The record is 121 days.
Wow. Wow. On your own for 121 days, you must have had a brief chat with them. I can't believe that you wouldn't.
Yeah, I mean, the snakes used to chat all the time.
Of course,
They were, by the end of it, we were friends.
Of course. As you are. Well, who was your favourite snake?
Favourite snake, I had a little snouted cobra in the room, and...
Everything sounds vaguely suggestive.
Yes. Hang on a minute, snouted cobra. Yeah. We called him half-cocked. Okay. Now, Russell, I must show you a little bit more of my room, OK?
Is there a snake?
Because I've already told you that I was living in a room with 40 venomous snakes.
Yep.
Okay, so what I thought I'd do is just bring you a little example, okay, of the actual snakes that I was living with.
Okay.
So what I'm going to do is just open this up here and give you a couple of examples there. Okay.
Yeah.
And if you'd like to just move your head or pull that out of the way as well, we've got a few snakes in there as well.
Yeah.
Okay. Mind your feet.
Oh, God, that looks like Voldemort, mate. I ain't going near that. Literally. No! You're that bloke in Star Wars. That bloke in Star Wars in Jabba's palace.
You wanna wonga?
Now.
I ain't going near you, mate.
Do me a favour.
Yep.
Can you just lift up your seat?
Yes.
Thank you. No, lift it up. Lift it up.
What, the whole thing?
The whole thing. Lift it up. No, lift.
From the bottom.
Yeah, right. Not there.
So from there, yeah?
Just gently lift this seat up.
Right.
Go on.
Yeah.
Go on. There you go.
Yeah, but I thought he might be under there and I thought I might die.
Okay. The snakes that we have here, the python that I'm holding and these guys here, are all non-venomous snakes. The guy that you've been sitting on, he is venomous.
Right. Oh, it's so weird, man. I'm not going to hold it. Look, it's terrifying. Will somebody have a go for me?
Yeah.
Do you want to have a go? Come on, madam. Right, you pretend to be me.
Okay.
Sweet. What's that? What the fuck is that? What's all that I've never done, man? Yeah, it looks very heavy. Watch
it's
out.
It's pretty heavy. There you go. You got him?
Oh. I'll be honest with you. Now, pretty sexy. Pretty sexy. Well done. What's your name, madam?
Joe.
Hey, Joe. Have you ever done anything? Look, you. Well done, braver than me. Well done. Thank you so much. Ladies and gentlemen, Joe Stronger! Put him away from me.
Come on, Russell.
I'm not. I just can't. I'd love to do it. I just haven't got the bravery. So, can I shake your hand and see you later?
You'll have to come closer.
I will. There you go. Ladies and gentlemen, please give it up for my Mr. Yes. Did you hear about the porn company planning a trip to a sleepy town in Kent?
Now, there's outrage in Deal after an American company making adult movies said it plans to bring a roadshow to the town to encourage local women to strip off and take part.
It's called Girls Gone Wild, and they want to film local women in their underwear.
They want to take photos of women in Deal. If they want to find British women willing to bear all, they should have just gone to the National. They will not find that in Deal. I've been there, it's full of pensioners. The high street is like a scene from Cocoon, right? Just Horlicks and Werthers. Can you imagine the kind of pictures they'll take?
That's it, ladies. Spread them. Really spread them. Is it hard? It looks hard.
Yes, it is a bit tricky.
That's it. Four fingers. Stick them right in. Now put them in your mouth.
Do that Kit Kat, but between you and me, I'd rather suck cock.
Do you know the weird thing? That wasn't even in the script. This week's final story is excellent. It's about Aaron Wheels Fotheringham, who, despite being born with spina bifida, lives his life to the max. Check this out, it's absolutely brilliant.
I have spina bifida. It's something to do with your spine. It's a birth defect, and I've never really researched what it is or what it does, just because, you know, I just don't really focus on that. My first real trick was a 180 off of a box jump, and that took me forever just to get that rotation, you know, throwing your head and stuff. And after I did that, that was cool, but I got bored. I was like, that's cool, but that's boring. I need something else. Then a bunch of bikers and stuff were like, you know, it'd be cool if you could backflip on a wheelchair. And I was like, that would be pretty sick, you know, I've never even thought about that. It feels like a dream. Like, right now I think I'm just like, you know, I think I just got a concussion and this is all going on in my head. I'm just scared to wake up, you know? Like, I don't want to wake up and be laying out in the skate park, you know? Because this is more than I could ever dream of. Things have happened that I never thought would happen.
Very well. How brilliant was that? It's Saturday night, which means it's stand-up time. Now, this next bloke is called Joel Dommett. He's very funny, and he lives on the same road as my mum and dad. So, so, ladies and gentlemen, or he used to, they've now moved. But not because of him, you know. He's very funny. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to stage the excellent Joel Dommett!
Yay! Yay! Oh, all right, how's it going? Good? 10 people, that'll do. Come on, guys. Missed Hollyoaks for this. Let's fucking still. Oh, the fan of Hollyoaks. Or were you in it? You look like you might have been in it. Oh, it's great. It's kind of got weird. It's weird being here because I came to watch the first series here with my ex-girlfriend, right? And I know I'm not gay, it's weird. And it's strange, we all for it. We all for it. I'll tell you, everyone's always thought I was going to turn out gay. Everyone, like, my parents always thought I was going to turn out gay. That they're still holding on, but like, it all started when I was about 14. I went through this weird goth stage, right? And so I used to like wear all the makeup and the eyeliner. I used to paint my nails and stuff. I don't know whether you noticed something about this face, which makes it terrible for goth styling, right? Way too smiley. Doesn't work. It's smiley. And we'd be like, we'd all be sat on the bench and everyone else would have their, like, their painted nails, their whole long hair, the makeup. They look frightening. I just looked fabulous. I looked really great. That's nice. I don't know. It's weird. Like, it's good to be honest, though. This is something I'm sort of discovering, right? I met this German man, right? This is his problem. What I love about German people is they're just beautifully honest. Like, too honest, right? Is there any Germans in? Give me a cheer. Oh, brilliant. Good on you. Right. I haven't got time, to be honest. But I met this German person. He was brilliant. Here's the problem. I was too honest, right? I was in the lift at Elephant and Castle tube station. And I just went, I like your coat. And he just went, I hate your shoes. Why could you be so mean? That's so weird. Because I'm not like a fighting person. It's not like I can fight him. Like, look at me. I'm not a fighting person, clearly, right? I've only ever had one fight in my entire life. Just one, right? It was in a nightclub on like a dance floor, right? And just this random man just started punching me in the eyes, right? So I'm trying to defend myself in like the only way I know how. I'm just fucking... I was doing a pretty good job at this point, right? It was pretty excellent. And then I remember a bouncer came in to save me. I remember saying to the bouncer, while still fighting this man, this man was being like, oh, what took you so long? Yeah! And the bouncer, honest to God, went, sorry, mate, I didn't think you were fighting. I thought you were dancing. I'm not dancing. The best fight I've ever seen in my entire life, though. This is the most incredible fight I've ever seen. It was in Cambridge. It was about 3 o'clock in the morning, right? I did a gig there, and there was this huge man, like this huge, huge guy, picked on this tiny, tiny, like geeky Cambridge man. Like, the difference in size was absolutely stupid. Like, the only way I can describe it is, you know, like the gladiators, like on gladiators, right? And like the contestants on Gladiators, like it looked the same difference in size. Like the little guy looked like he'd be like, oh, my name's Brian and I'm from Bristol. And, like the big guy'd be like, oh, my name's Hunter and I fuck women. But this massive guy just went to punch the tiny man in the face, right? Just went to punch him in the head. The only move that the tiny man had in retaliation was incredible. This is all he had. He just went, no! That was all he had. And then because he put his no arm out, the massive guy then had to go like over the no arm to punch him in the head. So he got this overarm motion here. And in doing the overarm motion, he dislocates his own shoulder. This huge man. He just like falls on the floor. He's like screaming in loads of pain. He's like, ah! The little guy's looking at his hand, just like, I think I'm a superhero, did I? And it's like, because he's screaming loads of pain, loads of people crowd round, right? Loads of people. This tiny man has never had so much attention in all of his life, right? There's loads of people looking at him, this huge man screaming in loads of pain. See, this is genuinely what he did, and it blew my mind, right? He's just in loads of pain, he just goes. I'm trying to keep fit by riding a bicycle, right? And this is my own thing. Like, I love riding a bicycle a lot. It's amazing, right? But I tell you, I crashed, right? This is 3 weeks ago. I crashed on my bicycle. And is there any bicyclists in? Give me a cheer. Yeah. It sounded like a bike horn, ironically, was it? Basically, like, I was going along Waterloo Bridge, right? And any fear for any bicyclists here, right, is a parked car opening their car door, right? And I was going along, like, properly quick, right? And, like, proper fucking quickaroo. Never said the word quickaroo on stage before. Thought, well, I'm gonna fucking pick a TV appearance to start it. By the way, actually, I'm going to tell you now, today I realised that I'm actually not quick on my bicycle, right? I'll tell you for why. Don't even know that makes sense. But I was going along Old Kent Road near my house and I thought I was going proper quick. I was like, yeah, I'm fucking going some, right? This man overtook me on his bicycle, just leisurely, just like, I'm overtaking you, right? He had absolutely no hands, right? Like, on his handlebars, he had hands. That'd be weird. He had no hands on his handlebars, right? In his right hand, he was holding a mobile phone. In his left hand, he was holding an eclair. What does that mean? I have no idea. But anyway, I crashed on my bike, right? So I was going along Waterloo Bridge, and this guy opened his car door, right? And he was about as far away as me to the brr guy, right? And, so I slam on my brakes. And, like, instead of, like, so I lock my wheels, and, like, and instead of, like, hitting it at full speed and flying over the door, because I slam on the brakes, I kind of hit it at a slow speed, fall into the man's lap. It was so weird. It was the weirdest thing between two men ever. He called me, like, Patrick Swayze. He was just like, hey. And, like, these are the two words that he chose to first say to me, right? I haven't heard these two words together since I was 9 years old, right? He caught me and just went, nice skid. What does that even mean? And so I kind of got up straight away. I was like, I'm sorry, I didn't mean, sorry. Got straight back on my bike. And but he just gave me a compliment, so I felt like I needed to give him a compliment back. So before I rode away, I just went, comfy lap. Weird. I have to tell you about my flatmate. He's absolutely brilliant. He came out with this phrase recently. He went on a date, right, and he didn't come back. So I asked him on the obvious question of, like, oh, so did you have sex, right? And he said back, he was like, oh, no, didn't have sex. No, but we did everything but. The creepiest phrase ever. It's not the creepiest phrase, because... To me, it doesn't even say anything. It's so weirdly nondescript. It's like everything but. It's just like, oh, did you have sex? No. But we went rock climbing. Pretty sexual. Really weird, right? And you seem like a sophisticated bunch, right? I've been trying recently to be more sophisticated. And so I thought I'm going to go watch a play, right? Oh, you're like sophisticated and go see a sophisticated, cultured play. So I thought, I'm going to go watch The Lion King, right? I didn't even get to watch it, though, because this man came up to me in the street in Covent Garden, right, with a flyer, right? Just comes up to me, and he's just, like, proper serious, just goes, come and see this one-man play. It's cutting-edge theatre. And it's free. That is everything I could ever want from an entertainment experience. So I'm going to go to this. It's going to be incredible, right? I call up my flatmate. I'm like, mate, we got to go to this play. It's going to be amazing. He's like, wicked, Joel. I'll meet you there. I'm like, perfect, right? And I asked the guy, I'm like, oh, what's it going to be like? Right? That's a serious man. What's it going to be like? He goes, absolute quote, he goes, it's kind of like Billy Elliot. But edgier. Oh, this is going to be amazing, right? So I go there right away. I go there, right? And I think there's going to be loads of people in there. It's going to be packed out. I get there. There's just one other person there, right? This lovely old lady who looks like she's been there for 48 years, right? And no, my flatmate fails to turn up, right? So it's just me and her. And then, like, this man comes out of the curtain and embarks upon this long, serious play by himself, right? The same man that gave me the flyer as well. It's always a bad sign, right? Just comes straight out of the curtain, just comes straight out. Just like, oh, monologue. Monologue. I'm paraphrasing, but, like, you get the idea. After about 27 minutes of this, I'm sat there like, how is this cutting-edge theatre? This is terrible, right? 27 minutes in, he then does what he quite clearly thinks in his brain is cutting-edge, and he starts to remove his clothing. He's then completely naked right in front of me in this tiny theatre, just like, monologue. Monologue. I'm sat there like, how the fuck is this like Billy Elliot? monologue. I think, oh, this can't get any worse. This is terrible. This can't get any worse. At this point, he goes behind the curtain, gets a full bottle of red wine, right? And then he starts to pour the entire bottle over his sweaty, naked actor body. Yeah? My point is like, oh, monologue. At that point, I'm like, oh. Should have seen The Lion King. I genuinely, right, I wouldn't have minded if just, if when he gave me that flyer in Covent Garden, if he was just honest with me, do you know what I mean? If he just gave me the flyer, it was just like, hey, in 33 minutes time, my penis is gonna be a foot away from your face. I'll be dancing in front of you with red wine all over my body. About 37 minutes in, I'm gonna flick my hips. And a bit of red wine is going to come off the tip of my penis. Into your surprised mouth. I wouldn't have believed him, but I wouldn't have believed him. It's absolutely happening. And at this point, the woman beside me, the only other person in there, she then gets up and leaves. She's like, I've had enough of this, I'm going. I'm like, I really want to go with you, like, really badly. Then I look at this man, like, stood there with, like just his socks on. I'm like, I can't leave. Like, he's chasing his dream, bless him. It's a fucked up dream, but it's a dream nonetheless, right? So I stay, basically, I stay. I made the decision, I'm gonna stay. So I sit down, but then I realise, as soon as she is gone, it is now just me and him. And it's gone from, like, awful play to, like, awkward lap dance. And at this point, I think this definitely cannot get any worse at this point. It absolutely cannot get any worse. At that point, my flatmate then walks in. I'm sat there like, oh, this is the worst thing that's ever happened to me. This naked man in front of me with red wine all over his body. My flatmate just walks in, just like, oh, sorry. Oh. Yeah. Hour and 40 minutes that play was. Yeah. Oh. I left afterwards, my flatmate was just sat there, just waiting for me. He was just sat there waiting, and I was like, you've been waiting here the entire time. Like, you've been waiting for an hour. Why don't you just, like come in, man? I needed you. And he looks over, he's like, oh, sorry, mate, I thought you were gonna have sex or something. No! We pretty much did everything, but... Thanks very much. If any of you are on Twitter, then follow my mum. She's hilarious. She's fucking brilliant. I've been Joel Donovan. Have a nice evening. Take care. Bye.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Joel Donovan.
Hey, maybe my mum and dad shouldn't have moved. Ladies and gentlemen, I hope you enjoyed watching Good News. Take care. Farewell.
See ya.